for special interests, including foreign corporations, to spend without limit in our elections. Including foreign corporations, to spend without limit in our elections. Including foreign corporations, to spend without limit in our
elections. It was close enough for you. First, you have the president calling out the Supreme Court, right? And doing it right to their faces, by the way, which is in and of itself kind of unusual. And then you have Alito's reaction, which is even more unusual. And here's something else. Let's watch the Democrats now, because they're standing right behind Alito. They're led by Senator Chuck Schumer in the row that's right behind Alito. You'll see him right away. We've got this video for you to look at. And I'm just going to ask the question. Could this be construed as them somehow taunting him? Watch.
Corporations to spend without limit in our elections.
That's about as invisible as we can be. We've shown you every possible angle and every possible solution or every possible explanation. Now let's go to the expert. Jeff Toobin joins us now. You ever seen anything like this before?
I loved it. Are you kidding? I thought it was great. Look, I thought this was a terrific civics lesson on what the Supreme Court is and what the Senate is and what the president's role is. I thought what the president says was entirely appropriate. The Supreme Court is fair game. I also thought what Justice Alito did was totally appropriate. If the president's going to get in his face, why shouldn't Alito respond with that very modest, apparently saying it's not true? I think this just shows how much the Supreme Court is in the middle of our politics, and it was a perfect illustration of that.
And how about those people out there who are saying, wait a minute, the Supreme Court justice is not allowed to render any kind of opinion? As a matter of fact, while we were watching the State of the Union last night, we noticed they were the only ones who never applauded for anything, not to appear as if they were taking sides.
You know what? I think you have to remember something about Supreme Court justices. They are human beings, and they have feelings about these issues, passionate, intense feelings. And there's also a bit of history between Obama and Alito that's worth remembering here. Mm. Because Obama was a senator when Alito came up for confirmation, and Alito and Obama voted against Alito.
Oh, I didn't know that.
January 14th, the week before Obama was inaugurated, he paid a courtesy call on the Supreme Court with Vice President-elect Biden, and 8 of the 9 justices showed up. Who was not there? Samuel Alito.
So maybe these guys don't like each other.
You know what? It is possible.
Why not?
I don't know if they don't like each other, but they are political opponents.
Okay.
That's what they are, and I don't think there's any reason to pretend otherwise.
Let me do what I hate. Let me try and not do what I hate when I watch sports channels like ESPN, and they show a coach getting thrown out for arguing with the umpire.
Right.
But they never show me the play to actually let me know whether it was a bad call by the umpire and the coach was right to argue. Let's talk about what seemed to incense or upset Alito. The president suggested that this ruling, and this is something you and I talked about, by the way, 3 or 4 days ago, that this ruling empowers foreign corporations. And that seems to be what Alito then responds to, and we hear him say, not true. Is Alito right to be mad? Is the president wrong to tell the American people that this ruling that they made empowers foreign corporations?
Well, let me unfortunately give you a bit of a lawyer's answer to that question. What the ruling says is that corporations have the right to give money in political campaigns right up until election day.
Uh-huh.
In part of the opinion, it says, Justice Kennedy actually wrote the opinion, it says, we express no opinion about whether Congress could pass rules regarding foreign corporations. So they explicitly don't say one way or another. Now, it could be interpreted, and President Obama interpreted it this way, that it was a green light to foreign corporations. But it didn't explicitly say that. So I think both sides have a legitimate argument. But, I mean, Obama could say, well, that's the implication. And Alito could say, well, we didn't say that explicitly. But as so often in the law, it's a little bit of a gray area.
We'll leave it there. Thanks so much,
Jeff.
Always enjoy my conversations with you.
All right.